Three more fights, as exciting as it is. Heating it up.
Okay, so I believe this is our 11th fight tonight.
Yeah,
we had the one exhibition from the two that failed, and then, yeah.
It's been a great night of fights. Man, oh man.
And we're just getting into the head of all the heavy action here coming up. Right now we got Packard and Shields coming up, and we have the 185-pound and 175-pound titles on the line tonight.
Yes. And if you're watching this from home and listening to us, you still have booze, I'm pretty sure. And you will see, Paulie is always with his family, lots of fans following him. American Top Team, great fighter. That's gonna be an interesting fight. And you're gonna hear the roar of the audience for sure. This is gonna be, the crowd will make it interesting. Pulley.
Yeah, their boys are ready to go.
But this is not gonna be an easy fight for any of them. It looks like it's gonna be a very interesting animated fight.
Straightforward. Straightforward. Action, action, action.
Yeah, they got right in the corner.
They went straight at each other.
Pulley went real fast. And
this is going to be one of those barn burners.
Yes.
We should have already known that when we seen it. When we seen it come out. No love loss here, I don't think.
Yeah.
Come
Tiger giving him a little further instruction. Keep it clean, guys.
Yeah,
keep it cleaner.
It's better to watch if they do good kickboxing instead of just doing a lot of this. I mean, both seem to be
trying to get in there and get it done.
Yeah, they seem to be very dynamic fighters. That was an interesting kick up there.
Right over us here, right over us. Like I said, Kiko, when I say best seat in the house,
yes,
I'm not playing around.
It is.
We get a view that most will ever never really understand.
So, you know, as typical, when things settle a little bit, now is when you're going to start to see, you know, how these fighters react to the distance, to and again,
they're all over each other, that's for sure. Look at the crowd too.
Yeah, and again, the southpaw versus the orthodox.
There's a lot of people watching this fight personally, here in person.
Yes, yeah, the local kid has all his family here.
You see, they got some.
Yes.
Yeah.
American Top Team, Paulie has a lot of fans here in town.
ZZ Top.
Mm-hmm.
Love it.
So you don't have to be a super genius to know that the second round is always different. And so I don't think the second round will be as crazy.
I want to see if they can keep up that tempo
and
for another round like that.
Right. But now is when they have to start mixing it up a little bit. Let's see if they can manage to get some kicks low, high, punches, knees, mix it up a little bit. But it's another southpaw versus orthodox, and it's always interesting. Now the southpaw is doing a better job, just moving outside.
To slip, yeah.
It was, yeah. It is.
Woo! Boy, they're fast, man.
Yeah. They're both.
Both of them are lightning fast.
Yes.
You can see they're conditioned very highly.
Yeah.
They both look like they're super ripped, you know.
Yeah.
Looks like both of them put a lot of hours into their training
for
this fight.
Now, it's being interesting that the.
The support here for these guys too.
That Packard has a very interesting high front kick that he's used a couple of times, and it was it landed somehow. I mean, not clearly, but I think that he could take advantage of it. It's a very good unutilized technique. Paulie has a lot of spirit, of course, a lot of support here in town, but now he needs to start just mixing it up a little bit. Now, one of the good things that Packard did is just he turned around from that corner real quick. He did a good job getting out of the trap. Let's see, we're going to the final round on this one.
Pretty active fight so far.
But it's not one of those where you see a lot of clarity yet. I would love to see more clarity on both fighters to see if they can capitalize on distance and combinations. they haven't been able to break the code of the other, of each other.
Right.
Mike, third round.
Blue corner's up, ready, rock and roll. Red corner took those extra few seconds. I would like to say that they got to be damn near exhausted, but they don't really look exhausted.
Yeah, no, they are very well conditioned, as you said before.
Yeah, it's apparent in their physique. The physique
yes.
gives that off.
But they have to now start defining things better to be more crystal clear with their punches and kicks. It's making it easier for the judges to judge this thing because right now it's difficult. And I don't know if you've noticed, but none of them is using the jab or anything like that, and they should to just get
big,
in there.
Big hard punches, looping punches, and kicks.
Yeah, and they should kind of go back to basics on their boxing.
Punches and bunches, double up the jab.
Yeah. There's some fighters
that
have to work on those basics again, right?
Yeah, I do agree with that 100%. You know, take some of the wild out and add a little bit more of the structured, fundamental technique.
And it's not bad. It's always good to go back to those things. This is, you know, a third round when everybody's tired is a very good place to start just doing basic stuff, but very effective.
Because then you score effectively.
Yes. So now this is the time to just get those jabs in. If you're going to throw low kicks, then follow up. So a lot of this is like...
They're using the brute force, you know?
Trying to
manhandle each other.
Right. Try to knock someone out when, if it doesn't happen, then your techniques are not clear. See, we're already 10 seconds away.
Now. Let's see how this goes. See if they turn it. Oh, he caught him with one right. He caught him with the right hand.
And, so maybe the judges will contemplate that as something, but again, to me, there needs to be some more clarity in these things. You have an opportunity to be clear, crystal clear.
It looked like they had plenty of energy.
Right.
Neither one of them is exhausted.
Yeah, and I know that both have probably the technique to do it. But they were super excited to probably put a show for the family or whatever, and then you lose it a little bit. So making it difficult for the judges is always a risk.
Here we go. All three judges score this about the same, 29-28, for your winner by unanimous decision, Paul the Transformer Shield!
Bitch, I look so damn good right now. Excuse me, I'm feeling myself from my head to my toes.
And this is what happens when you don't let things too clear to the judges. But the aggression, of course, in this case of Paulie, made all the difference. And here he is, hailed by his crowd, very happy, as usual. I'm happy for him too, and let's hope that he can keep growing and progressing in his technique. Now here's the crowd just making it even more fun for him.